trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here? Wait, there's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there. So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit. Shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence? She had a brilliant eye. So, she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work. I prefer Robert Frank.
Me too, Victoria. He captured the essence of post-war beat America. And there was honesty about the
economic conditions. I can't believe I still have his pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
You don't have beauty
without a beat. But I like it old school.
Which explains why Frank was Kerouac's photographic muse. And both were the great chroniclers of the 1950s.
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here. Plus, it's perfect for my portfolio. And I have to get my daily selfie quota.
Capturing the romantic urban solitude of the 20th century poet. You dig? Now, contrast Frank's stark Americana with Salvador Dali's surrealist.
Shh.
I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert
Cornelius. I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should.
You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass.
You're submitting your photo for the competition. Everybody in class is turning in a photo, so you see the dilemma?
I know, Mr. Jefferson. I just worked so hard.
I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
Shot, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed by your work. I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event, and I want to represent Blackwell.
Hi, Kate.
You have just by participating.
Hi, Max.
By putting yourself out there in the world. Now, no matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel excluded.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
That this photographic world is not for everybody. I had my moment in the camera eye, and everybody should have a chance.
I only want to share whatever.
I think Victoria has already won the contest, as usual.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Yeah, me too. Talk to you later.
Sure.
Huh. This might make a cool shot. Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I didn't have any time. Way too much homework.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I feel like you
always
welcome to the real world.
Cute.
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
Because Max wants everybody to see how hip she is.
I'm not paying $150.
She plays it so sharp.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
You remember that it's payday?
Yeah, payday.
I hate bully jockstraps like Logan. And he's a Vortex Club member.
Your ass.
Yeah.
Your ass.
Logan, seriously, leave me alone.
Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan. I wish October would last forever. It looks like she's been gone for months. They should just call it a sugar machine. That would be awesome if you put money in there and a bag of sugar dropped out. Empty. Good. Nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me. Now who would bother to write that crap? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us in our...
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color
to... Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit!
Can you give me an example of a photographer...
I cannot believe this.
...captured the human condition in black and white?
Okay, if I'm crazy,
anybody?
I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arvis?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like total...
Can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arvis?
Because of her images.
Keep it together, Max.
You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence? She had a brilliant eye, so she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work. I prefer Robert Frank.
Me too, Victoria. He captured the essence of post-war beat America, and there was honesty about the economic conditions of the era, but a beauty in the struggle. You don't have beauty without a beat, which explains why Frank was Kerouac's photographic muse, and both were the great I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie, a dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition, and Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
of course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation.
So
was
I can go
first
back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography.
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not gonna get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class.
Was a French painter,
and I need time to save that girl.
Types. A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind
the
again and give him the right answer?
Out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yes, Victoria, you still have... I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Yeah, I'm not sure I have one.
Given your selfie output, I'm sure you must have about 1,000 pics by now.
It'll take a long time to find a good one.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework this week. Even if you're submitting your photo for the competition, everybody in class...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that science class with those nerds.
What's that got to
do? Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do!
Wow, sir, it's happening again.
People trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more
trouble. I need a hammer to break it open.
Control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
I need a hammer to break it open.
Hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Oh, shit! No! No, 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 no! And miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
I'm too scared to get near this psycho.
No! No, 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 no! Don't ever, ever tell me what to do. I'm so sick! Sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even...
Hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would...
Max, you're going to get hurt.
Miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
To control
I'm
me!
I'm too scared to get near this psycho.
Hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody... would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho! Get that gun away from me, psycho! Drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they? No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. Don't wander around here. Get on outside. Hold on, Max. Come back here. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
class.
Just
tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet. Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth.
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around. In the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family. And one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's it? After what I told
you? We'll continue this discussion later, in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
This day has been so insane. Everything is happening too fast. And none of it makes any sense. These visions, this power. I keep expecting to wake up one more time. But if this is a dream, then I'm not asleep. Which means somehow I did rewind time. So there has to be a reason, and I have to find out why. Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive. Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to thrash?
Oh yeah? Bring it.
What's your first move gonna be?
Jump?
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to thrash?
I came to nose slide. But I'd love to see somebody do a tree flip.
Oh, sick. You're not a poser.
Nah, I just can't skate worth shit.
Aw, oh, check it. We're gonna destroy some rails for you. What do you want to see?
Go for a tree flip.
Let's get Trevor all over that action. Oh, ow. Ooh.
What's up, Daniel?
Oh, hi, Max. Could I, ask you a question? Would you mind letting me sketch you? I do put my sketches on Facebook, though.
I'd rather not, Daniel. Not that I don't want you to.
Never mind. I guess you would be too ashamed. Now, I have to get back to my drawing.
That's one of his famous shots. I love how it captures the moment. Clever. Hello?
Max, I don't feel like talking.
Oh, sorry. I won't bother you. Evan's portfolio always looks so uber pro. I'd love to see his photos in there.
Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
Steve McCurry?
Unless he could travel back in time. McCurry was born 5 years after the falling soldier picture. McCurry also shoots in color. In other words, no portfolio.
Come on, Logan, bring it, brah. Yeah!
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Yeah! Oh. Hi, Max.
What are you reading?
Love Today or Die Forever. Don't even say anything.
It's a bestseller.
No.
What to say?
Good point. Now if you'll excuse me.
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose.
No.
So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way. There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps. None shall pass. Capiche?
Ah,
Awesome!
Damn, I missed something. I better rewind. Samuel is way too close. A paint bucket next to Victoria. I can't grab that. Samuel is way too close. Okay, let's see if this works. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way. Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
What the hell? Thanks so much for almost ruining my outfit. You're so lucky that didn't fall on us. We'd see your ass so fast.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Awesome.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way. Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
What the hell? Thanks so much for almost ruining my outfit. You're so lucky that didn't fall on us. We'd see your ass so fast.
Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket. Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
What the hell? Thanks so much for almost ruining.
Okay, let's see if this works. A paint bucket next to Victoria.
I see a plan.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Nice, bro.
No way! No fucking
way! You okay,
way.
Victoria?
Oh, Samuel is sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max? Don't say a word, Max.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose. And no filter needed before I post this. Now, please move. I've had a messed up day, and I'm going to my room.
You do that? I know where you live. So does Nathan.
Yeah. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Now I have to get to my room, then see Warren. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Nice, bro.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me.
Awesome.
You deserve a better shot.
Yeah.
Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
No. I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Better get to my room before I find Warren. Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long. Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon. Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot. Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball. Hard to believe I'm 18 now. I'm lucky my parents enabled my photo habit into adulthood. Instant film is so damn hard to find and expensive now. But I can't help it. I'm analog, not digital. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Let me out, Juliet. This is so stupid.
Answer, you wuss.
Hey, Juliet.
This is so stupid.
Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
Ridiculous.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care?
Don't let me out.
Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
Answer, you what?
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here. Dior, Givenchy, you could pay for my tuition with that wardrobe. I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article. Victoria is a real Jefferson groupie. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Ugh.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren. Dana really does look stressed about all this. Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Victoria is not nice. I don't get it. She has everything. And to pull that prank on a friend?
Just because they're in the Vortex Club doesn't mean they're BFFs. I'm in it, and Victoria creeps me out. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing. When you opened the flash drive, didn't you see the special folder called Max?
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Are you blushing? Go ahead and grab the flash drive whenever.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
This shit.
Ow! That hurt!
Damn, I better rewind.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but Now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business? I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied. Who toilet papers a bike? The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster. Damn, somebody is seriously devoted to putting up these posters.
Come on over here, please.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zack yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Max, get your ass over here. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
I don't want to talk about it.
Jeez, you're a little missensitive today.
I wouldn't push your luck, Warren. Not in the mood today.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Not at all. Sensitive is good, unless you're a pushover. You have hip taste and a quick mind.
Thanks for noticing, Max.
The right girl will too.
If I was lucky,
Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now. Answer me, bitch!
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
And did what, give you a stern lecture?
Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt, and you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah, must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Broken. Man, are you cereal?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes.
Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate. So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Party all night.
Not Little Miss Wallflower. I bet you've never even been to a party.
Oh, right. I went to your birthday blowout.
Max, you were 12 years old. That's sad. You should stick to taking photos.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her.
It's here, Max. Look a little harder.
Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play. I think this junk swallowed her discs.
You broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Chloe's dad built this dresser.
I know my room is a disaster, but you can find a disc. Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
So, who is she? Do you mind talking about her?
Rachel Amber. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything. Nope. Someone locked it from the other side. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks. Cool, now it's opened. This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes! Break it down, Max.
Chloe, are you up there?
Yo, turn it off! Turn it off!
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on! Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around. Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door. I'm giving you exact...
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You've been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth, that's an order. Whose is it?
Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon!
Hey, leave Joyce out of this.
I wish you'd leave Joyce, like now!
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother and you just keep pushing me.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time. Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast!
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe... Someday you'll grow up.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real step douches of Arcadia Bay.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
That's hard to believe.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today. Birds are so lucky, they can always escape. Sure you don't want to be alone?
Sit down if you want.
Are you pissed at me?
I just wanted some backup.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
I should have taken his photo when he flipped out on Kate today.
That would be killer blackmail material. Let's bust his ass.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
What files?
David stashes his secret X files in there. I saw them once, but he secures them now.
He kind of creeps me out. I bet the truth is out there in his files.
Most likely, but it's good you didn't find his files. He would go ballistic. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe, I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
happening to me? Why am I here again? Is Chloe still up there? I have to find out. Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away. Oh no. The tornado is headed straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.